This is the second video in our series, which is taking a look at creating a toy from both NURBS and polygon geometry. Right now I'm working on the sphere that's going to be used for the body. And in the last video we created this and examined some of the properties. But right now I want to get this seam running down the back of my chicken. I don't really want that cutting straight through the front or randomly on the side as it is now. To do this, I'm going to hit E, which will allow me to grab my rotate tool, and I'll rotate it just a little bit so that it's more closely oriented towards the back. This will just allow me to see what axis I've rotated this on. If I enter the channel box, you'll now see that all of my channels should read 0 and 1 except for one channel, the rotate Y channel, which indicates in this case a value of 37.2. Well, if I just take this value and rotate it a full 90 degrees by clicking on the value next to rotate Y and then typing 90 for 90 and hitting enter, you'll notice that my model will actually lock itself to be right along that back edge. So now that if I look at it, it's going to be facing forward along the Z axis. This is going to be the back side. I'm going to hit W to grab the move tool. And I'm going to pull this up just a bit. And also, I think now is the time to maybe start to scale this out a bit. However, you'll notice if I go ahead and scale this, it's actually going to scale it out in a way that keeps the seam really running down one side. But what I'm actually looking for, I want to keep the pole maybe right up around the head. So if I can rotate this forward before scaling it, that might be a little bit more beneficial to me. So I'm going to hit E for my rotate tool. Rotate this so it seems like it fits that axis line. And then see if I can scale it out. Now to just edit the form a little bit more, we can see essentially what is facing forward and what's facing backwards. And we can see that I've put that seam along the back of my rooster. I'm going to hit spacebar to enter my four panel view, and you'll now see essentially what's going on in each of these views, that my sphere is facing forward in the front view, and that we can see it very clearly from the side in the side view, which by hitting spacebar, I'll enter. I'll right-click on the model and choose Control Vertex from the marking menu. Now, I can grab a selection over these vertices. Sometimes it's actually easier to grab the lasso select and just draw your selection. And then I'll hit W, which is the hotkey for the move tool, or I'll go to the toolbox and grab that. Move this up a little bit. Hit E, which is the hotkey for the rotate tool. And grabbing either the outer yellow arrow or the, loop, or the blue loop, I'll be able to rotate this directly along that side plane that we currently see. And I can kind of pull this back a little bit. By just tweaking these vertices a little bit more, I can start to get my rough jelly bean shape that I was talking about earlier for this rooster. Now I've got my photo open just beside me, but it's always advisable to have an actual version of your toy in front of you if you're doing this. So here's my rooster shape. That's what we eventually have in our model. So what we're going to do now is we have to actually take a look at building this wisely. Now, what I mean by that is I don't want to have to make manipulations on both halves of the model. In fact, if I touch this vertex over here and I move it, I want this to work symmetrically so that the same thing happens on the other side, that I don't have to build both sides of the model. To do this, I'm going to separate this model in half, straight down the center, and I'm going to create a special type of duplicate called the duplicate instance, which is going to allow me to have an active copy on the other side. To separate this model, I'm going to right-click on it and choose isopart. Now, this is particular to how NURBS geometry works. It asks you to essentially slice your model along one of the already existing isoparms. to do this, I'm going to select this isoparm running along the back. And I also have to select, to complete the circle, I have to hold down Shift and select the complementary isoparm on the other side. If this was a globe, it would be the equivalent of selecting both the international dateline and the prime meridian. I'll then go to Edit NURBS and choose the option Detach Surfaces. And if we're lucky, it should actually cut it in half. Sometimes you need to repeat this process. But in this case, it's decided that we do not. Now that the surface is detached, I can delete out that one side, and I'm left with just my good, correct left side of the model. Well, you'll notice that my axis is currently right along that center line, and all of my control vertices are along the center line for my model. Well, regardless of this, it is always helpful before making a duplicate special to come in and freeze your transformations. What we're going to do is we're going to go to Modify and choose Freeze Transformations. And then we'll do Modify Reset Transformations. And this will make sure that all of my translate and rotate values are reset to zero and that the scale is set to a value of one, that the pivot point is back at the origin while leaving the actual model in the same place. Since I have a model that exists in the positive x direction and I want to copy it to the negative x direction, I'm going to make a duplicate special, just like I looked at in the previous Making a Chair videos. I'm going to go to Edit and choose Duplicate Special and go to the Options box. Here, I want to establish that my scale is going to be set to negative 1 on the x-axis. And again, this is alphabetically x, y, and z. If I hit apply right now, I'll have sort of a dead copy. It'll copy it where it is, but it's not going to keep updating as I update my left side. If I switch the geometry type from copy to instance, however, I'm going to have an active copy. Now I'm going to hit apply, and I'll show you what I mean. I'll close this out. Hit spacebar, and spacebar again to return to the perspective view. I'm going to choose a single isoparm on one side, and notice that it automatically selects the isoparm on the far side for me. Now, as I edit this model, you'll notice that as I move the vertex on one side, it automatically moves for me on the other side, which is going to help keep my model exactly symmetrical. Now I can make some easy changes to this piece. Changes that, again, will start to reflect the overall shape of the bird that I'm going for. So let's see if I can change this up just a little bit. Narrow this out by the tail. Maybe widen that little back piece a bit. Whatever I do, however, at all costs, I want to make sure that I'm not actually taking any vertices that are along my center line and moving them off the center line, because as you'll see, that will open up my model. So I've made a couple of quick tweaks. See if I can make just a few more. And this is going to get my shape rather well established. This will be round enough for the head. So there we go. That's video two. In the next video, we're going to take a look at adding some more geometry to this bird after the fact.